This is Comedy Fight Club! Comedy Fight Club and the big dog, Mark Henley.
Y'all get it twisted. This rap shit is mine, motherfuckers.
What's up, Comedy Fight Club? How you doing tonight?
Fuck what you hearing.
How you doing tonight?
It's what you hearing.
This is Comedy Fight Club. The guy stuff show said about me stays in the edit of the show. How you guys doing tonight? This is Comedy Fight Club. This is a roast battle show. This is a show where people say mean shit. You guys right here, people say mean shit. People are gonna say controversial stuff. Would you two like to start us off with a controversial statement?
I'm a faggot. What's up?
Comedy Fight Club. I preview the battles. I tell you who's battling, and I give you an idea of what to expect in the battles. The first fight tonight, Oscar Aiden versus Christy Miller. Oscar Aiden is a known gay man. And my dad is gay, so rooting for him is going to feel a lot like rooting for the home team, baby. But then I thought about it, and Christy Miller is a woman. And I don't know if you guys know this, my mom is a woman too. So what is the home team after all, guys? I still think Oscar Aiden's gonna win this one tonight. Actually, change my mind, it's Christy Miller's gonna win tonight. Christy Miller is very jacked. I think everyone was very scared for a second. Next up is gonna be Alex Sklar versus Rebecca Kaplan. Before the battle, I was talking to Alex, and he told me that he is a Jew that is uncircumcised. And what covenant did Jews make with God? You must be circumcised. Alex is a man who stands in defiance of God. He looked God in the eyes and said, "You're dead, we killed you." What is Rebecca Kaplan going to do to that? A lot, because women can do anything. Guys, I think Rebecca Kaplan's going to win tonight. The next battle, Jesse Townsend versus UB Thomas. Yeah. Recently, who's that basketball player with the crazy hair? Dennis Rodman liked one of Jesse Townsend's tweets. Have you guys heard about this? Have you guys heard Dennis Rodman likes Jesse Townsend? Who else does Dennis Rodman like? Kim Jong-un, Donald Trump, Jesse Townsend. He's a great judge of character. He only likes badasses. Guys, UB Thomas might be in trouble. Jesse Townsend's gonna win this one tonight. And the last undercard battle, Jared Schwartz versus Ronnie Smith. Jared Schwartz is a comedian with a catchphrase, and that catchphrase is, "Y'all trying to chill." He is a man that is always trying to chill. But is that an advantage in roast battling?
No.
Is roast battling all about chilling, or is it all about hate? It's all about hate. I think he might be unprepared. Ronnie, do you have hate in your heart?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, he
does. Let's go.
Ronnie's gonna win this one tonight. You guys excited for that?
Yeah.
And the main event tonight, the main event. All right, so why do you guys think we do roast battles? What is this for? Is it for money? No, is it for success in comedy?
No.
No. It is for what?
Blood.
Blood and glory. And it's from, what do you get if you are the glorious winner? You get the Comedy Fight Club Championship. The Comedy Fight Club champion was Sean Gardini, but he got too busy, so we need to find a new Comedy Fight Club champion. Sean Gardini defended it once against the big dog, and I'll be honest, it was one-sided in his favor. But he was scared off, and we need a new Comedy Fight Club champion. So we got two contenders. We got in one corner, Pat Haggerty. Pat Haggerty is one of the most polarizing and unpredictable roast battlers in the whole of Comedy Fight Club. Some think he can't write jokes, some think he is the greatest joke writer to ever be in Comedy Fight Club. I'm a little on the last side of it. And then the other one is, full disclosure, a roommate and best friend, Ben Miller.
Yeah, Ben!
Ben Miller is a man that is a very nice guy, but he loves one thing above all, and that is the rules. One time we went to go see an art house movie together. Yeah, we do smart guy shit when we're alone. We went to see a movie, and during, you know, the part before the movie where it tells you not to talk during the movie? He quietly clapped to himself. And that taught me two things. One, he loves the rules. Two, he hates people that don't follow the rules. And what does Pat Haggerty not follow? The fucking rules. Ben Miller, he's gonna make him pay for not following the rules. And he is excited tonight. I know he's excited to go because he invited his cool guy brother Gabe to watch him battle. Will Ben win the Comedy Fight Club Championship, or will he embarrass himself in front of his brother Gabe? That's what we're gonna find out tonight. Guys, this is Comedy Fight Club. We're starting a new championship. Let's get this new Comedy Fight Club.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Comedy Fight Club. Please welcome your commissioner, Matt Merritt!
Tonight, egos will be wounded, feelings will be hurt, because we don't come here to make friends. We come here to fight! This is humiliation, this is brutality, anything goes, no holds barred. This is Comedy Fight Club! Thank you all for coming out. Welcome to Comedy Fight Club, coming to you live from the Stand Comedy Club! Holy shit, this is a really big night tonight. I am the official commissioner of Comedy Fight Club, Matt Maron. Yeah. We are on Twitter and Instagram at ComedyFightNYC, but our social media hips are not here. Filling in, recording for us tonight, we got Johnny Glover and Brandon Bowles. Most of you guys have been here before, but those of you who haven't, this is a roast battle show. People are going to be saying real mean, vicious, fucked up shit to each other, stuff you're not supposed to say, but we're here to have a good time so no one's going to get offended. Does that sound good? Woo! Go over the rules here at Comedy Fight Club. Each undercard fight's going to be 5 jokes, tit for tat, and the main event's going to be a little bit longer before it. We'll go over the rules when we get up to that. But the winners of each of these fights are going to be picked by an amazing judges panel. Fight Club, give it up for our judges! Yeah! But up first, not sitting to my left, sitting in front of me right now. From this point forward, each and every single one of you is Comedy Fight Club. Because your applause is going to count for 1 vote in each of these fights. Which means, Fight Club, I need to have a whole lot of fucking energy. What do you say? You have some energy for me tonight? When I ask you who you think the winner is, you will clap for 1 fighter and 1 fighter only. You will not clap for both because we can't have 2 winners. Which leads me to the most important rule here at Comedy Fight Club.
No fucking pity claps.
No fucking pity claps. This is Comedy Fight Club. This is where sympathy comes to die. Someone's going to lose up here. You will let them lose with dignity. Now let's meet our judges. Up first, one of our favorites here, one of our house judges of Fight Club. Started off killing it at LA's Roast Battle. He's killed it at Fight Club here. Give it up for Robbie Goodwin.
Hello.
What's up? How you doing tonight, Robbie?
I'm good, Matt. I'm starting to think Sean Gardini had the right idea. I gotta start listening to that guy more. I love that it's like, this belt is so important that the guy who had it got a little busy, and now my roommates are fighting for it.
It's the most
prestigious sounds like a coveted piece of belting.
It's the most prestigious prize in all of entertainment. Watch your mouth, Robbie.
Watch your mouth, man. I don't know what the fuck you just said.
Watch what you said. It's a close battle.
Sorry, man. I'm a little ornery because you told me to get here early and then started an hour late.
Make sure you get there at 8:50 because we're starting at 9:50.
Okay, it's a half hour late and the title is very important. Robbie's just lying to you people tonight.
Call me the Lion King.
Yes.
All right. All right. I didn't.
I want you to hear your run come to an abrupt halt right now.
I'd almost rather it bomb than just get one. That almost might have been preferable.
Robbie, you've judged the show a bunch before. You've been on the show. What's your advice to the fighters coming on stage tonight?
Man, just have fun, because whether you win or lose, it's not going to matter at all. So just have a good time tonight.
Maybe you too one day can become too busy to be the champion of this show. Fight Club, give it up for Robbie Goodwin. And up next, another one of our favorites here, co-host of the Shift Podcast, Fight Club. Give it up for Katie Boyle.
Hello.
What's up, Katie? How are you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. How was your bomb cyclone snowstorm?
It was fine. It was great. Yeah, we're here. I mean, I wish you'd canceled this, but yeah. You know, it could have been a lot better.
Katie, you've judged the show a bunch of times before. What can the fighters do on this stage to get your vote?
Just, you know, be funny. That's really it. That's really it.
Just be funny and cancel the show so Katie doesn't have to come out to
do it. Yeah. Be quick. I want to go home.
Fight Club, one more time. Give it up for Katie Boyle. And up next, she's a regular here at the Stand Comedy Club, Fight Club. Give it up for Onika McLean.
What's up?
What's up? How you doing tonight, Onika?
I am wonderful. I had my little nap, so now I'm ready to go.
Yes. I'm so happy we had you on the show about a month or so ago for the first time. You were fucking great. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling like I want to hear some really good written jokes so I can laugh my ass off.
Hell yeah. And what is your advice besides writing good jokes? And that's just good advice, right? Good jokes for Comedy Fight Club. What can they do to stand out to you?
It's always about the energy for me, baby. So yes. If you bring the energy with your punchline, bop, 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 I'm good.
Awesome, Fight Club. Bring some energy. Write good jokes. Just actually basic comedy advice. Just be a performer and a comedian on the show. Fight Club, one more time. Give it up for Onika McLean. And up next, host of Only Feehans, another one of our favorites here. Give it up for Karen Feehan.
Hi, guys.
What's up, Karen? How are you tonight?
Thanks for having me, Matt.
Yes, thanks for coming out. You get to judge your protege, Jared Schwartz, tonight.
Which I love doing. I'm sorry. I feel like I've canceled on you a few times. And then the one time I get to do it, you book me with 18 women.
Yeah, we wanted you to be able to stand out and be one of the funnier people on the judges panel this time.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, awesome. Fight Club, give it up for Karen Feehan. And our final judge tonight, we got a full house from Comedy Central, host of the Great Hang Podcast. Give it up for Micah Fox.
Thank you.
How are you doing tonight, Micah?
I just love seeing really great roasts, and I will settle for tonight.
Bunch of fighters coming up on stage. A championship match tonight. What can the fighters do to get Micah Fox's vote?
I don't know, bring the judges one more microphone? How are we supposed to talk all over you if there's only one mic?
We have two mics.
Hell yes.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, we're like Jeff Ross, two mics. Three, or Neil Brennan, whatever, fuck it.
All right, then I guess my advice is just be yourselves.
That's terrible advice, but give it up for Micah Fox anyway. And give it up for all of our judges tonight. And before we get started, the show would not be possible without our amazing officials. Up first, you saw him earlier, the big dog, it's Mark Henley. And he is in our championship fight tonight. He'll also be closing us out tonight, the official goofball of Comedy Fight Club, Patrick Haggerty. Maybe my favorite part of the show, it is our amazing DJ. Fight Club, I need you to give it up for DJ Don't Believe Women.
I'm a flirt, soon as I see her walk up in the club.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Fight Club, what do you say? You ready to see some fights tonight?
Yeah!
No, I need more than that. I said, are you ready to see some fucking fights tonight? Yeah! Let's get this started. Up first, we have an undercard match scheduled for 5 jokes, tit for tat. Introducing first, he's gay and Middle Eastern, so good up for the only Arab who loves getting invaded by foreigners, Oscar Aiden.
You're all homophobic. I just want you to know that. No, no, we're not doing that. No, no, no.
We're gonna meet your opponent now. She looks like Lou Ferrigno, fuck the Rocky Horror Picture Show, Chrissy Miller.
And you'd still fuck it.
Chrissy, Oscar, 5 jokes, tit for tat. Which one of you wants to go first?
She can go first.
Oh, I'm always the top.
Chrissy's going first. Oscar's going second. One more time, Fight Club. Are you ready for this fight?
Yeah.
5 jokes starting with Chrissy. This fight starts now.
Oscar looks like if you ordered Mario Cantone off a Wish.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chrissy Miller, or as she likes to be brought up on stage, the strongest man in Hell's Kitchen.
And you'd still bottom for me, bitch. You human glory hole.
She's not wrong. She's not wrong.
100%
oh, this is on,
fact,
I'm sorry.
Bitch. Oscar's so gay, his blood type is AIDS. Come on, bitch.
Oh, Chrissy. Chrissy is a comedian. The
Why are you looking at him? Look at them, you
oh,
cock.
I just couldn't stand looking at you.
Because I always fuck them from behind, that's why.
Here's
the pillow biter.
Sir, I'm talking.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know why.
I have no idea.
I don't understand why white men always have to interrupt me. Here's the thing, Matt. Chrissy is a comedian the same way Caitlyn Jenner is a woman. They're not.
Oh, I wish you were a comic. Even his asshole is a bringer show. You gotta bring 6 so he could do a tight 5, and not even that tight, bitch. I'll work on that one.
Why are you gay?
Oh, were you done?
No.
Oh, I just heard rambling.
No, that was the inside of your asshole.
I don't know.
Your easy pass is
it's
going
amazing.
On.
It's amazing, Christy. It's amazing that you can do so many steroids, but you can't take anything to improve your comedy. I know.
Yeah, you know.
I know. I wrote that half hour ago.
Yeah, it shows.
Sorry.
Just like your act. He is brown, gay, and Muslim. He's one vagina away from being a shitty lineup at the Tiny Cupboard. Yes, sir!
That's pretty good.
It's called writing, you cock.
She kinda got that one. I'm not gonna lie. I mean, the only other thing I wrote is, like, this is the reason why J.K. Rowling is getting canceled. I know.
God, you even bomb on stage like you're doing a fucking building.
My God,
building.
She's coming towards me. Oh, my God.
Oh, that's what you said like last night, coming towards you, coming on you.
WWF over here. You know what is the wrestling one? What's the WWF?
Are you done, girl?
Okay, yeah.
All right, queen.
Don't, really.
You may leave the stage.
Okay, thanks.
You know, I really, my favorite joke you've ever said was when Jeff Dunham had his hand up your ass going, silence! I kill you! That's a good fucking joke, people. Go fuck yourselves.
Are we done?
That's
a great fucking joke. All right, let's see. God, this is awful. Christie's bangs. I love her bangs. You've had them forever. I think the only reason she has them is to hide her penis.
Yes, sir! Because it's so big, bitch. You want to suck it. Do I get one more?
Sure.
All right.
You may beat me up, so yeah.
I really want to destroy this terrorist. I mean, terrorist.
What was it? I just had it.
Oh, Oscar's adopted, by the way. I don't know if you guys know this. So he's searching for his birth mother because he ran out of people to bring to bringer shows. I know, that was bad. I shouldn't have ended on that one.
Can I go back and say no?
Yes, please do.
Fight Club, give it up for your first fight of the night. We're going to you guys first, Fight Club. Do you think the winner of this fight is Oscar Aiden? Yeah.
I'm shocked.
Or is the winner of this fight Christy Miller? Crowd vote goes to Oscar. We'll go to our judges. Robbie Goodwin, we'll start with you. What do you think of this fight?
Fee, fi, fo, come. This is fun. It was like watching Gay Vitel versus Joe Rogan in a wig. That's kind of what that felt like. You guys, it's funny because you guys like Freaky Friday voices. Do you guys notice that? All right. 0 for 3. No. My favorite thing was that Oscar, his entire strategy was like he was gossiping to Matt, and her entire strategy was going, "What'd you say about me, bitch?" I mean, I'm gonna give it to Oscar just cause I think, I'm sorry, what was your name again? Christine?
Christy.
Christy, yeah. And nobody will, but this was definitely interesting tonight. I thought you played a little dirty cause you like kinda like stepped on his jokes a lot and like he was just trying to do his thing and you were like kinda like literally almost about to step on him and his jokes. So I'm gonna give it to Oscar.
Two votes for Oscar Aiden. Katie Boyle.
I'm gonna give it to Oscar, but I'm also terrified that you're gonna beat me up afterwards, so please don't. And again, only for the same reason, just cause, yeah, I thought it was more fun. I know that you had well-written jokes, and I know I had said that earlier, but I really enjoyed your gossipy. And please don't kill me, I'm gonna pass this on.
Another vote for Oscar, Onika.
So I do like the stuff that you wrote. It was just that you were so busy focused on him, you weren't like just delivering, you know what I'm saying? So that they could got it. But I'm gonna go with Oscar because your stage presence is just amazing.
Another vote for Oscar Aiden. Karen Fina.
I've never seen a jockey fight with his own thoroughbred. This was a thrilling battle.
Which one was which? Can you tell me that?
I get what Katie was saying now. You look like if the Incredible Hulk had rosacea.
No, I like you. You remind me of like what I would look like if I never quit drinking. So it's like a good, it's a good reminder. You're kind of giving me like Chloe after Tristan's 12th affair kind of vibes. All right, I started off really hot. I think I'm gonna. Oscar, you're a vicious homosexual. Do you know that? You're a mean girl with a dirty butthole. You're bad.
Yeah. It's another vote for Oscar, I'm pretty sure. He's got it wrapped up. And Micah, final thoughts on this fight?
You know, I'm torn because I...
Like Oscar's asshole?
I usually like automatically vote for the woman, but I can't figure out who that is. I guess, okay, you know what? I promised I would give it to Oscar because I love him and because he did a better job, but I'm gonna throw you a pity vote. Thanks, Chrissy.
You don't have to. Give it to Oscar. He was better, dude. Don't give me a pity. I don't need pity.
No,
bitch.
No.
Abuse me, bitch.
You'll accept the pity and feel bad about it tomorrow.
Oh, it's dirty. It's dirty. Dude,
Micah's the crazy enough person here that would actually fight Chrissy after this. But Fight Club, great first fight. Give it up for your winner, Oscar.
Oh, my God. Wow, I can't believe that. Thanks, Matt.
What do you say, Fight Club? Are you ready for more fights? I need more than that. I said, you ready for more fights? Introducing first, he's from Russia and his mom is a real Moscow, Alex Sklar! And his opponent, her pussy's so dry and undesirable, I call it Neil Young's discography, Rebecca Kaplan! Five jokes, tit for tat. Rebecca, Alex, which one of you guys wants to go first?
I can go first if you want me to.
Whatever you want.
Alex is going first. Rebecca's going second. This awkward date.
I gotta ask for consent. Come on. I learned my lesson last time.
Five jokes starting with Alex. This fight starts now.
Rebecca used to be part of a comedy sketch group called Fresh Out the Box. Really ironic considering there's nothing fresh about Rebecca's box.
Yeah, Alex usually likes pussy smoked like a, I don't know. Arf! That's my impression of Alex's girlfriend faking an orgasm.
First blood.
She stopped doing that. Thanks, Notorious STD. Rebecca actually failed a rape defense class. Luckily for her, nothing is a better defense against rape than Rebecca's personality.
Bing bong.
Yeah, Alex still tried it anyway. He likes some. He likes women, abrasive. It reminds him of his mom. Doctors call people like Alex who ride motorcycles organ donors, but little do they know Alex's dad and the Russian mafia stole them his kidneys years ago.
So. All right, so y'all just seen that corny ass shit.
Thanks, anorexic Tina Belcher.
Oh, no.
Oh. You got it. Nice.
Thanks for calling me skinny.
Yeah, I got more. Rebecca looks like she got kidnapped and chained to a radiator, but got released after doing 5 minutes of her stand-up.
Alex looks like he doesn't just slay puss, but also skins and eats it.
Catch me outside, how about that?
Good one, Hermione Stranger Danger. Rebecca actually suffers from partial face blindness, serious disorder, which means she has trouble recognizing faces. Also, a perfect excuse when someone hears her say that all Asians look the same.
Well, they, Alex's ex-girlfriend had some of the sex, some of the best sex she's ever had in her life when she was with him. They were in an open relationship.
I'm smart.
She left me when she found someone better. It's true. By the way, thank you, gender neutral Mr. Potato Head. Rebecca's a Jew. In accordance with the Jewish tradition, her body's flat like matzah. A real miracle, given the amount of yeast in Rebecca's pussy.
Oh no! No, 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 no! Oh no! No, 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 no!
Well, how much yeast is trapped between your foreskin and your parents should have cut that thing. That's disgusting. I'll do it right now if you want.
Do it in your teeth,
bruh.
Alex. Alex treats women like Russia treats Ukraine. He likes to enter without permission.
Fight Club, give it up for Rebecca and Alex. I've seen a lot of roast battles before. I've never quite seen I will circumcise you used in a battle before. We'll go to our judges. Micah Fox, we'll start with you. Who do you think won this fight?
Riveting battle. Truly can't contain my thoughts on this. I mean, Rebecca, it was fun to see what was going to happen first. You would find your punchline or your pants would find your waist. Do you think it was you? Yeah, the risky. Do you think it was a good idea to put those jokes on your suicide scar?
People need
kinda
to
like
know.
A bad luck, you know, fool me once kind of thing.
They need to know why I died.
He's got the quarterback then.
I'll let him know.
Just as much brain damage.
I'm gonna give this to Rebecca. Great job, funny stuff. I hope you cut his dick off.
One vote for Rebecca Kaplan. Karen Feehan.
This was great. I was gonna say, weird, I'm a cutter flex. You're so fucking cute. I'm so jealous of you. Like, you can say whatever you want, because you're like fully autistic, right? Like, you're like 100%. I'm like, she can be racist, it doesn't matter. We're like, it's so cute. She's like so autistic. Like, I'm so jealous of how free you are. And I'm gonna give that round to you, so congrats.
Another vote for Rebecca Kaplan. Fight Club will go to you guys now. Do you think the winner of this fight is Alex Sklar?
I know.
Or is the winner of this fight Rebecca Kaplan?
I don't do well in real elections, I'm sorry.
Crowd vote goes to Rebecca. Alex, dig the hole deeper. Onika McLean.
I couldn't help but look at your nipples the whole time. I was like, is it cold in here or is it me? Because, damn. Okay, sorry.
Too many female judges for me.
Oh, sorry. And so I'm going to give it to Rebecca, but I'm like into fashion. Girl, please. Oh, shit. That's a lot of colors. I'm going to take you somewhere. I'm going to help you out.
Please record that. Onika giving Rebecca a makeover. Hell yeah.
I think you need to take me too, because I think she looks great. Oh, like these butts. I love them.
Katie, what do you think?
I
I realize this might be inside baseball, but I don't know. Are you Rebecca or Jacob Williams with a wig? Not fully convinced. And you, Alex, every time you said a joke, it was like we'd asked Alexa for a joke.
I was trying not to...
And are you his girlfriend?
Me?
Yeah.
I wish.
Oh, okay. I thought because you. I was like, okay, that's great to hear. That's great to hear.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
She just came in the mail.
Yeah, you felt a. Did you see that when you said I'll bite off his circumcision dick thingy? You were like. Oh, okay. You were defending him a lot, like he didn't want his dick eaten, and I was like, whoa.
Cut the shit off in Russia. And the political shit is really sensitive.
Okay. I regret this. It's okay. You're not putting.
No, let's take a break from the show and get deep into this circumcision politics.
I pick Rebecca.
Another one for Rebecca. She's got it wrapped up. But Robbie Goodwin, your final thoughts.
Oh my God, we're surrounded by Ruskies. I'm so uncomfortable. Rebecca is going to do some great victory knitting later tonight. This is... Jimmy fucking fist pumping those needles in the air. You're a maniac. That's for sure. It was awesome, because you had no confidence on pretty good jokes, and you had way too much confidence on statements, mostly. This reminds me of like the end of an 80s teen comedy, you know? The Mousy girl lets down her hair and sicks it to the Russian, you know? At prom. But yeah, man, I'd wish you'd poot in a punchline, buddy. Folks. Yeah, I'm going hot, or should I say, I'm hot, except cold. I'm eating cold war. What, all right, yeah. I fucked that up. Rebecca Kaplan'd that at the end there. I'm giving it to Rebecca. Great job.
Another vote for Rebecca Kaplan. Fight Club, give it up for your winner, Rebecca Kaplan.
You win. You win.
We need a sidebar for a second.
Yeah, everyone heard that. That's so funny.
Fight Club, we got two more undercard fights than our main event. Are you ready for your next fight? Introducing first, he's like Pete Davidson if instead of hot women, he got Down syndrome, Jesse Townsend.
Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on a surface.
He looks cold and sweaty to drop bombs.
And his opponent, he looks like the guy from Allstate if he were a pedophile, UB Thomas. Five jokes, tip for tat. UB, Jesse, which one of you guys wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Jesse's going first, UB's going second. One more time, Fight Club. Are you ready for this fight? Five jokes starting with Jesse. This fight starts now.
Yeah, I may look like Pete Davidson, but you look like his dad on September 12th.
If you don't know a lot about Jesse, Jesse is actually a gender-neutral name. So before all this non-binary shit, it was called a Jesse. Oh, wow.
Thank you, Nipsey Side Hustle. Yubi's dad abandoned him, and now he's dead. But don't worry, he died doing what he loved, being far away from Yubi.
First blood.
All right, good one, Jesse. Good one. As you can, as we can all see, you know, you're tall. You're about 6'5". You're blonde. You're talentless. You used to be fat. If you were a female, you'd be Brigitte Nielsen.
What a reference!
They don't know who Brigitte Nielsen is.
Can you tell he's 41?
Uh.
It's a shame he's wearing the beanie right now, but UB, your hairline's a lot like your father. It's never coming back.
Oh, man, I love it. Jesse, you know, Jesse used to be fat, ladies and gentlemen. He lost about 100 pounds. Give him a round of applause for that. Big, yeah. Hell yeah, yeah. When he was fat, they called him Round Jesse. If you look under his skin now, he's just called Loose Skin Jesse.
Wow, another good one, really. Thank you, Eazy-E, if the E stood for extra AIDS. UB left his wife and kids to do this? That's the joke.
Yes, sir!
I did a lot of research on the actual, on the name, Jesse. So, you know, Jesse, hold on, y'all, listen. Jesse actually means, in Hebrew, it means gift. The same girl broke up with him twice. She returned him like a gift from Amazon.
Bruh. UB has two kids. One is half white and the other is fully abandoned.
You're the reason New York extended the abortion law.
Last chance. Oh, that's okay.
UB stands for Unknown Boy. It's a nickname that every club in this city has given him.
Oh man, this has been a fucking disaster.
You don't have another banger lined up? Really? What a plot twist!
Yeah.
Who would have guessed?
Yeah, yeah. No more definitions. No more definitions.
What is his last name?
Look at
mean?
This guy. I don't know. Townsend, motherfucker. Townsend. He's a white, slinky, ugly motherfucker. You look like a diabetic pedophile, motherfucker.
Fight Club, give it up for Jesse and UB. I didn't realize how old you were, UB. Seriously, I'm sorry they took Neil Young's music off Spotify. We'll go to our judges. Robbie Goodwin, we'll start with you this time. What do you think of this fight?
Well, unfortunately, UB stands for you bombed. Nah, this is fun. This is a good high school reenactment of 8 Mile. boy. This is like Jesse roasting who Jesse sees when he looks in the mirror. But in all seriousness, score one for the whites, everybody.
White power, white power.
Score one for the whites. UB, I will say this, Jesse was all cocky, but it's only because you were bad. If you weren't that good. It was like, you pulled out a real Biden victory there, buddy. You just kind of stood there while that guy fucking torpedoed his chances.
Fuck, I gotta go to DC to make UB the winner now?
Come on, man. I'm going to give it to Jesse, but, you know, I don't like that you're tall and skinny.
Thank you.
One vote for Jesse. Katie Boyle.
Yeah, I'll give it to Jesse as well, but you guys know you don't have to do this. Like, you had a choice to say no. And Jesse, if you weren't white, I would think that you were the kid he abandoned. You're very, very similar. Also, stop putting the mic up to your chin. It's disgusting. Okay. It's very distracting.
Two votes for Jesse. Fight Club, we'll go to you guys now. Do you think the winner of this fight is UB Thomas?
Yeah!
Bruh. That's my family back there, goddammit. We support win or lose, goddammit.
Savino and Barnes, injury attorneys, 800-888-8888.
UB got the vote from whatever's left of his family. Or is the winner of this fight Jesse Townsend? Crowd vote goes to Jesse. Onika McLean, will come to you. What do you think?
UB need to start writing. That shit was so bad. I couldn't believe it. It was like bomb after bomb. I was like, maybe he doesn't understand what a punchline is. That shit was crazy. And Wow. I'm mad at you. Okay, so. Now I gotta give it to the white man.
I ain't getting no pussy tonight.
I had to tell the truth and shame the goddamn devil. I was like, God damn, whew. I didn't hit one bar. So I have to give it to you by default, but you are a mediocre white man. But that means you can be the president, so it's all good. Here.
Thank you.
Another vote for Jesse Townsend, Karen Feehan.
Thank you for answering the question, what would Pete Davidson look like with even less blood?
And more fentanyl.
That's why I didn't say it. I was excited when I first saw this. I was like, this is going to be good. This is like Kanye's revenge right here. This is going to be it. But I was fucking wrong. Another one for the whites.
Yeah. Another one for the whites. Another vote for Jesse.
Thank you.
He's got it wrapped up, but final thoughts, Micah Fox.
Two mics, Micah Fox. I can definitely tell you be 40, man. Goddamn. How the fuck old is that Bridget Nielsen joke? Why do you have your headphones on? You have like a Cyrano de Bergerac in there who wants you to fail? Just like whispering shitty jokes. You didn't even try to write one joke about him, and look at this fucking loser. Just look at him. Don't even think right now. Like, both his face and his pants are acid washed. But I gotta give it to him. I'm sorry, UB, you just sucked.
Another vote for Jesse Fight Club. Give it up for the winner of this fight.
Even
Jesse
Jordan
Townsend.
Had a bad game, baby. Even Jordan had a bad game.
The baseball Michael Jordan.
What do you say, Fight Club? Are you ready to see one more undercard fight before our main event? Introducing first, he's so unlikable being Jewish is his best quality, Jared Schwartz.
Truth is, I thought it mattered. I thought that music mattered. But does it bollocks? Not compared.
And his opponent. He looks like his SoundCloud rapper name is Young Retard, Ronnie Smith!
The pressure weigh a ton, it's getting too heavy. Had to fight, I'm gonna feel like I didn't already. Real ones still around, release the confetti. Godson across the belly.
Five jokes, tip for tat. Ronnie, Jared, which one of you guys wants to go first?
You want to go first, kid?
Nah. Jared's gonna go first because I'm intimidated. Ronnie's going second. Five jokes, tip for tat, starting with Jared. This fight starts now.
Ronnie's black. Good job. Ronnie's so black that even his punchlines are 20 minutes late.
You know, Jared, every time you talk, I wish the Holocaust was real.
Ronnie looks like the son and the dad who left him.
You know, Jared, I want to light your eyes on fire. I want to light your eyes on fire just so you can see what the audience feels like when they watch your set.
We notice how the laughs are coming from his boys.
You're bad at comedy. You should stop.
Oh, you got me.
Emotional, damn it.
Stop.
He got me.
You should stop living. Continue.
It's crazy that you're wearing a college sweatshirt when you definitely didn't go to college. All right.
Bruh.
You know, one thing.
That wasn't my joke.
That's not your joke?
Nope.
Okay,
nope.
Continue.
That was my joke.
That's
Ronnie looks like he believes that Santa and the Black Panther are real.
Suvino and Barnes, injury attorneys, 800-888-8888.
Don't wait, call 8.
One thing I've noticed is whenever Jared is on a show, they usually spell his name wrong on the flyer. So while we're
here tonight,
shows,
bro.
Huh? Wait, what'd you say?
I said, at least I'm on shows, bro.
You're on shows? Okay, well, I want to clear up the confusion for all the people who want to book you, Jared. That's what I want to do. So I'm going to clear up the confusion. For those of you that don't know, the correct way to spell his name is F-A-G-G-O-T. That's how you fucking spell it. That's how you spell it.
You cunt face cunt. Come on.
Okay. That was a good one. That was so aggressive. That's crazy. I've never seen him on a lineup. Ronnie.
He's been in plenty of lineups.
Ronnie was raised like a typical black kid, except when his dad went to the store, he left him and brought the cigarettes home. I know, because they weren't working with him either.
Boo this man! Nah, Derek, chill. You know something, Jared, I want to be honest with you. You can suck the energy out of the room the same way you suck the cum out of Karen Feehan's dick.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Last joke.
That was it. That was 5.
Oh, that was 5? Yeah. All right, Fight Club, give it up for Jared and Ronnie. This is going to be fun. We're going to go to the crowd vote first. Fight Club, do you think the winner of this fight is Jared Schwartz?
Yeah, white people.
Ho, shut the fuck up.
Or is the winner of this fight Ronnie Smith? Crowd vote goes for Ronnie Smith. Starting to sound like a movie theater in here. We'll go to our judges. Micah Fox, we'll start with you. Who do you think won this fight and why was it Ronnie?
You know, I'm just so happy to see Jared fail. I'm sorry to say, you know, listen, I've never met you, but can I buy you dinner? Not really, like, as a joke, but... No, I can't even do this. I don't even... Karen, you deal with your mess.
I think that's
about, shut up, stupid.
I think that's a vote for Ronnie. Karen Feehan.
I feel like there was like some real animosity going on up here. Like this seems like very real. Like there's some like behind the scenes stuff going on. Am I right?
I don't know, maybe it's because I've never booked them.
Oh. Yeah. I mean, you guys both look like the kids that nobody wants to sit with at lunch. I thought you guys would be like friends. Like, sorry? I thought you guys were gonna be like more like get along, like tit for tat. This felt sort of real. Like I think I gotta take my kid out of this public school. I think we're gonna take our money elsewhere, babe. Okay.
I think that's also a vote for Ronnie. Anika McLean.
Yeah, I'm voting for Ronnie. Damn, that was a good joke. But you came over here. I said, what's about to happen? It's getting nervous. Damn, Jared. Yeah, that was fucked up. But yeah, I,
would think that y'all both would be like friends. It's like y'all both got the same kind of Asperger's. It's the same. It's just in the black schools, they didn't treat us quick enough. And you've been on the meds for a long time. You gotta leave the meds alone so you can write the jokes. Make it quicker. I'll tell you something.
Katie Boyle.
Yeah, the bottles are getting really, I'm afraid. You guys are scared. If you were white, I would think you were a serial killer.
Yeah, because black people never kill people.
Yeah, not the way white guys do it. They like eat your skin and shit. And I think you might do that, but you do what you want to do, just not us. Yeah, that was really, do you guys actually hate each other? Is there
people? No.
Oh,
I have no idea.
Oh, I
could care less.
And it is for Ronnie, but you're so sweet. That was me.
That's just what you want to hear. I think you told a bunch of jokes of someone who saw it say, "You're so sweet." Robbie Goodwin, your final thoughts.
Looks like the whites and blacks are tied once again. I like this, Matt. A nice even race war. This is great the way you're booking this.
Yeah.
Man, poor Jared. I like you, man.
Oh, thank you.
Not just because you remind me of a time-traveling Rich Voss, but other things, too. Yeah, I actually feel bad for Jared because after the last battle, I think we all want to see the black guy win, and Ronnie really delivered. It was like it was like a rapper meeting his number one fan. You know, he's like, what? it was almost like a reverse 8 Mile. You were almost like a Tarantino villain at times. You were like playing with your food, like, oh yeah, Jared, I like comedy too, and you fucking suck at it. So, very white of you to do that. Very white of you. And a black man with a white man's capabilities, you're dangerous, Ronnie. Jared, you looked like you had fun up there.
A great fight, but Fight Club, give it up for your winner, Ronnie Smith!
You win! You win! You win!
And now, holy shit, Fight Club, it is time for our main event of the evening! And this is a big night, a big fight. It is for the most prestigious prize in all of entertainment, the Comedy Fight Club Championship! These are two of our absolute fucking best fighters. They've both been doing the show for years now because their careers aren't good enough or they don't have to. I'm very excited for this. Two of the best roasters we have. So one more time, Fight Club, I need all the energy you have. Are you ready for your main event? Introducing first, from Staten Island, New York. He is the goofball of Comedy Fight Club. He looks like he apologizes for coming too early in the gangbang. Patrick Haggerty!
I'm Goofy Goober! You're a Goofy Goober! We're all Goofy Goobers! Goofy Goofy Goober Goober!
Those all the previous roast battle medals you've won?
That's right, I'm already a champion.
We are going to meet his opponent now. He is currently the number one contender to the Comedy Fight Club Championship. He's won several battles up to this point to get to this championship match, one of our fucking best, from Chicago, Illinois. He looks like a graphic designer who only works on child porn websites. Ben Miller!
Downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound.
Our main event's gonna be a 3-round battle, 4 jokes in each round. We'll go to our judges for feedback in between, but we're gonna pick a winner overall after all 3 rounds. Patrick, Ben, which one of you wants to kick us off?
I'll go first.
Ben's gonna go first, Patrick's going second. Round one is 4 jokes, tit for tat. Fight Club, you ready to get this fight off? 4 jokes starting with Ben Miller. This championship fight starts now.
Round one.
It's great to be here roasting this Gerber baby with a steroid problem. You look like you need to be burped after drinking a beer.
First blood.
Ben Miller is autistic. In fact, Ben Miller has a lot in common with Big Ben, the clock in London. Because Ben also has a big dumb face, and he's constantly, loudly telling me what time it is. Hey, it's 4 o'clock. Yeah, Ben, we know it's 4 o'clock. We have watches too.
Patrick is really into women's feet. It's not a fetish, it's just they're the same size as his.
Toasty! It's Miller time! That's what Ben Miller likes to say right before he rapes a guy with the skinny end of a beer bottle.
Having a catchphrase makes it more memorable, I find. So, Patrick isn't very religious because growing up going to Catholic school, he was filled with everything but the Holy Spirit.
I appreciate that.
That's right, everyone. Ben Miller is a rapist. But Ben Miller is a good old-fashioned American rapist. Ben rapes folks just like you or me, one leg at a time.
Emotional damage.
Last show.
You look like a jockey that lets the horses ride him.
Ben Miller has a condition that causes him to have a sunken in chest. Whoa, am I roasting Ben Miller or my ex-wife?
Give it up for round one of your championship main event. Yeah. We don't have to pick a winner yet, but thoughts after round one so far, Robbie Goodwin?
Oh, that was beautiful. Patrick, why are you wearing hiking boots? What the fuck are you doing?
They're great for the snow.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'll allow it.
Yeah.
This is fun. It's like the school shooter versus the jock. I really like it, though. I love Patrick, one of my favorites. Excited to see more.
Katie Boyle.
Yeah, no, I like it. Patrick does a funny thing with your jokes. It's like you're a grandfather reading the news or something. I have bigger the words on that page. Oh, he doesn't speak to humans. Okay.
Are you speaking to me?
I'm excited so far. No, I was talking to you, cunt. Anyway.
Onika McLean.
Oh, this is fun. Now we're down to the business. I really like the writing on both of you. You're just so
cool.
You know what you are. I can't wait to see the next round.
Karen Fee.
Ah, oh, thank you. You guys are both so hot. It's crazy. Like, thanks for booking all these fuckable guys, Matt. Round after round, all these hot, sexy. He does. He looks like a strong baby. I feel like he's gonna tell us all to start doing squats. But yeah, I guess he want. I know. I want to vote for you. What's your name?
Ben.
Ben.
Karen thinks Ben's got it so far. Micah Fox.
This is fun. Great jokes. I mean, Ben, right? Yeah, you look like you would like stare at me from across the street. And then Patrick looks like he would stare me right through the window.
Holy shit, Fight Club. This is such a fun main event so far. I'm excited to keep it going. What do you say? Are you ready to move on to round two of this main event? Gonna be 4 jokes straight through. We started with Ben last time. Start with Patrick in round two. This fight continues now.
Round two.
Ben Miller, you fat fuck! Now, some of you may already know this, but Ben Miller has a bit of an eating disorder. Yeah, he'll eat disorder and disorder and disorder and disorder. Hey, Ben, why don't you lay off the junk food, you lardo?
Perfect timing.
Ben Miller has a sunken-in chest. Yeah, looks like all what you lost in your chest went straight to your ass, you fucking fatty. All right.
Another one.
You're huge, Ben. Me and your father can barely look at you anymore. You're scaring us, and these dresses you're wearing aren't helping. I mean, is this what you want, Ben? To look like a whore?
And another one.
One more.
Ben Miller really enjoys using guns. Hey, Ben, maybe the next trigger you should pull is when you make yourself vomit so you stop being so fucking fat. Eres un desgracia.
Ben Miller.
You know, if Patrick sees his 5 o'clock shadow, it means 6 more weeks of no punchlines.
Toasty!
Patrick is a boy scout. He scouts out boys to have sex with. He is actually a highly decorated boy scout, so he's trained how to survive a bear, an otter, and even other twinks like him.
Oh, kill him! Oh, kill him! Oh!
When Patrick was getting his woodworking patch, his scoutmaster was so impressed, he also gave him a patch for swallowing.
Oh my god!
Last one.
You look like Captain America. Instead of the super soldier serum, they just gave him cum.
Perfect timing.
Fight Club, give it up for round two of this main event. We'll go back to our judges. Robbie, after round two, how are you feeling?
One second, everyone.
We got a second mic over there.
All right, well, all right. Hey, remember me, everybody? That was fun. Patrick Haggerty, more like your jokes didn't make any fucking sense that time. I saw you were going for Ben Skinny, but it's like, there's so many things about him you could pick that are true, you know? Like, he's skinny, that's funny. You know? Get it together, Pat. I'm rooting for you. Ben, you were great. Good job.
Katie Boyle, after round two, your thoughts.
I did not get that you were going for him being skinny. I was like, it just made no sense to me. But yeah, Ben, that was great. Loads of jokes. Come on, Patrick. A joke in the next one about him.
No, but looking at him is fat.
I guess you may, well, if I hadn't known that, I don't know. Ben.
Katie thinks Ben took round two. Onika McLean, what do you think after that round?
I think Ben.
Karen Feehan.
I love Katie Boyle so much. Like, come on, write a joke about him, would ya? Sorry. I think Skinny Hitler is really running away with it. You look like that, you know, the old guy in Home Alone? With like.
Oh, yeah.
You look like the ghost of him, like, you know, before. Sometimes it's not funny, it's just an accurate fucking example, okay? You're winning, Patrick, you're weird.
Oh, hell yeah, I love a battle where someone makes Ben seem like the normal person here. Micah Fox.
No, you did a great job, American Gothic. I don't know, Patrick, listen, man, if you're gonna steal Karen's act, deliver it better, all right? She hates fat people. Okay.
I've tried to just inflict body dysmorphia on people before. It's a good effort.
Great round two. We are going to go to round three right now. It looks like Ben's pulled ahead at this point, but we have another round, and then we're going to pick a winner overall. It's anybody's game at this point. What do you say, Fight Club? Are you ready to move on to round three of this main event? Started with Patrick last time, so now it's four jokes. Starting with Ben, round three starts now.
Final round.
When he was growing up, Patrick's older brother was his wrestling coach. Or at least that's what he said when his parents caught them.
Ben Miller's initials are BM. Which is fitting, because Ben Miller just got done shitting all over my chest.
Bruh.
Thank you, shoeshine boy who only uses his tongue.
Ben Miller, more like Ben Stiller, because there's definitely something about this Mary. That's good.
That deserves a boo lander.
Patrick, it looks like pepper spray is the only thing you've ever made a girl squirt.
Another one, and another one.
Ben Miller is really into science. Well, I'm really into algebra. Why don't you try this equation on for size? A squared plus B squared equals D squared.
Last joke.
It's just not how math works, okay? You know, Patrick went to nursing school, but he dropped out when he realized it wasn't a school for people that still want to drink their mother's breast milk.
Perfect timing.
You know, back in his hometown, they call Ben Miller Ben Thriller. They call him that because Ben Miller really enjoys molesting children.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
Like Michael Jackson.
Yeah, yeah, get it?
Give it up for your main event! Two of our fucking best. Fight Club will go to you now. Do you think the winner and new Comedy Fight Club champion is Patrick Haggerty? Or is the winner of this fight Ben Miller?
Let's go.
Crowd vote goes to Ben. Micah Fox, we'll start with you. Who do you think won this fight?
I mean, Patrick, why are you so loud? Like, you don't have to be that loud to get attention. Are you trying to transition into being a woman?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Oh, you're bad at comedy?
I'm gonna give it to you, Ben. Wear the win in good health as you live within these walls.
Another vote for Ben Miller. Karen Feed, man.
Ben, I thought you did such a good job. Every time you landed a joke, I wanted to throw a piece of chicken up there for you.
Not during Ronnie or UB's battle?
No, Ben looks like he could use some chicken. Matt, you're being so racist. My dog is... Yeah, I'll let Omika deal with you. Yeah, Ben won, sorry.
Another vote for Ben Miller, Onika McLean.
You guys look like Rugrats. I promise you. Damn, I was like, damn, that just looks like Chucky all grown up. Okay, Ben, I go with Ben.
Another vote for Ben Miller, Katie Boyle.
Yeah, I go with Ben, and I am going to walk home with my keys in between my hands tonight.
Terrified of all of you.
Ben, that was great. Write jokes, Patrick.
Great. You said great. You said great jokes. Thank you.
This is why you're single.
I can't understand your accent.
Okay. You're too busy mimicking Asian accents, usually.
Yeah. Oh, hello.
Toy, 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 toy. Yeah.
Robbie Goodway.
Toy, 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 toy. No. Sorry, it's infectious. Patrick, you could have used a little more luck of the Irish, actually. This belt is going to be way too big for Ben. That's all I'm going to say. How's he going to fucking get it on? Yeah, Ben won. Patrick, I'm starting to get convinced that all it says on that paper is scream. I love how you either hold it full arm's length or right up to your face.
I needed my hand to grab my nuts.
Oh, there you go. Okay. I love how you have strategy to what you do. I mean, I love it, Pat, but you shouldn't do comedy just for me. That won't get you anywhere. Ben won. Great job, Ben. Well deserved.
Another vote for Ben Miller Fight Club. Give it up for your new Comedy Fight Club champion, Ben Miller!
You win!
Hey, 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 hey. Ben Miller, new Comedy Fight Club champion. I know you all know you will never get too busy to defend this belt here at Comedy Fight Club. How does it feel?
It's honestly pretty surreal. I started roasting about 4 years ago at Comedy Fight Club. What? Oh, sorry. Oh, no. No speech?
Okay. We want to go home.
Folks, it's an honor.
No, I kind of want you to try and give a sincere speech while everyone hates you during it.
It's an honor to be your champion. I will face anybody who tries to take this from me.
Yes, I did. So I backed it up and brought it back to the clear. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like this. Just when you thought you guys had had enough, to wrap us up tonight, it's our goofball, Patrick Haggerty!
Goofy Goober! You're a Goofy Goober!
Whoa, what a show! Give it up for Comedy Fight Club! Come on! Wow, what a show! What a show! Comedy Fight Club, it's a great show, but I prefer Comedy Nightclub! Oh, hello, and welcome to Comedy Nightclub. I am your host, Matt Moringe. Esta noche. Dos luchadores entran al circulo de luchador. Pero uno solamente es victorioso. ¿Por qué? Nosotros no entramos por amigos. Nosotros entramos a lucha. All right, have a good night, everybody.
The goofball Patrick Haggerty. Now, Fight Club, I need to give it up for all of our judges, all the battlers you saw tonight. This show's gonna stream Thursday night on YouTube. Subscribe to our channel, youtube.com/comedyfightclub, patreon.com/comedyfightclub for bonus content, and 6 Feet Apparel. We got Comedy Fight Club t-shirts. Thank you all very much. Next week, we're at Bowery Electric. Have a good night. See you next time.